U.S. Ambassador Kelly Craft told the Security Council the Trump administration is committed to partnering with other countries and using U.N. sanctions to counter al-Shabaab's financing of terrorism and the threat from homemade bombs the group is making. The United States also remains focused on limiting the ability of al-Shabaab to conduct attacks against civilians, she said. The Security Council was focusing on the panel of experts whose latest report stresses the continuing impact of al-Shabaab's operations not only in Somalia, but in neighboring Kenya. Al-Shabaab remains the most active and resilient extremist group in Africa, controlling parts of southern and central Somalia and often targeting checkpoints and other high-profile areas in the capital Mogadishu. It has fired several mortars this year at heavily defended international airport, where the U.S. Embassy and other missions are located. Experts stress that military operations against al-Shabaab must be accompanied by non-military efforts to degrade the group's capacity and combat its propaganda. Its investigation found that al-Shabaab generated approximately $13 million in these four case studies alone. It assesses that the group remains in a strong financial position and is generating a significant budgetary surplus, some of which is invested in property purchases and businesses in Mogadishu.